Congratulations to you on the Cubs.
Thank you so much.
Lifelong Cub fan.
Yes.
Where did you watch?
I was maybe going to go to the game,
yeah.
But as I said, I have a commitment to the Seth Meyers show.
Yeah. I would have understood. I would have.
No, there's no understanding. And a promise is a promise.
If they ever go another 108 years, you can skip me.
And there might have been a Good Morning America commitment that was time constraining as well. But either way, the point is I'm here. But I watched it. So I watched it here in New York City with Mel Gibson, the director, Luke Bracey, who was on your show.
Yep, fantastic.
A charming,
young
dazzling young Australian.
Yep.
That's right. And some of the other team that was there. So we watched the game, and it was exciting. Did you find this game exciting?
I found it very exciting. You were
Did you have a dog in the fight?
I didn't, but I was, you know, as a Red Sox fan, I'm very happy that one of those cities would have relief that I felt, the relief that I felt in 2004.
And I understand what that relief feels like.
Is it wonderful?
It's unbelievable. I mean, it's just crazy to feel that, you know, I've always believed, and this year it actually came through. So it was even that last at bat, you know, there was a guy that if he hit a home run, that would have been the end in the other direction.
Yeah.
So when the final out happened, it was almost that moment of, did this really
finish off? You're about to enter a great period of freedom in your life where you'll just care a little bit less about it all.
Yes.
It's really nice.
Yes, yes, yes.
You'll start seeing the people in your lives, your family. Yes. They come into focus now.
Yes. It's...
And you have children.
I look forward to that healthy experience.
Yes.
Yes.
You have kids. Did they follow the Cubs? Did they care at all about this?
As much as a five-year-old can, who's force-fed it.
Yeah.
My daughter is almost six. My son is three. And people would say to me, well, gosh, do they even know what this means? And I said, no. But why would I belabor them with this painful history?
Yeah.
Right? Like, for all they know, the Cubs are a great team. Let's keep it that way.
Yeah, exactly.
Why not, right?
Yeah. Now they can move on in this brave new world that we're all...
We just love the Cubs. They seem to win.
You got to sing Take Me Out to the Ball Game.
Yes. And the offers came
in. You've done it before.
Well, the offers came in.
Yeah,
I didn't know that they wanted to travel with the play Pippin, but I'm open to it.
you answered the call.
I answered the singing call. That's right.
And it must have been fun. You've done it before, but to do it in the World Series atmosphere must have been fantastic.
It was. It was great just to be there and to be a part of it and sing the stretch. Was a lot of fun. I mean, we were down a lot in that game, so it was hard to try to figure out how you're going to muster it.
Right. But... And so then, and that must be nice. You must feel a relief, too, because the game you did it, they lost.
Well, here's what happened. They were down seven. it's a valid point. I like a direct conversation. Stick with us. This is going to go somewhere. So we were down 7-1 in that moment.
Yeah.
But a lot of people tweeted afterwards that from the time I sang, right, even though that game was late and we lost, that the score became undeniable for the Cubs. And a lot of people see that as the catalyst moment.
Turning point.
That was a turning point.
Turning point.
That's right.
Because they lost that game. Again, they couldn't catch up.
But we did score one run. We didn't give up any more. And then we won three straight. So, I'm just a fan of the game. But there's a lot of people out there putting the high beams on this guy. And guess who this guy is? The Seth Meyers
show,
baby.
There you go, man. Perfect.
Come on.